Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So we will continue with this series of videos relating to United Nations and its organs. I have already made three previous videos where we discussed regarding history of United Nations and we saw some questions relating to that part. Then some other provisions like the principles or purposes of establishment of United Nations, original members of United Nations, or original, the prime organs of United Nations, then official languages, that part we discussed in the second class with some questions. In the third class, we started with General Assembly, powers, composition, then voting and other process, and also some questions relating to that. So today's video is going to be the fourth one in this series of videos. If you have missed the previous videos, I would suggest you that you go to the playlist NTA UGC NET International Law, and from there you can watch all the previous videos and then you can continue with this one. So let's begin with today's video where we are going to discuss Security Council and we will see some related questions. But Security Council part we are going to discuss in two classes because it's a little bit lengthier topic. But before we go ahead with this class, I would request you to kindly subscribe to the channel so that you get notified regarding all the upcoming videos. So Security Council, as we know, is also one of the prime organs, right? Main organs of United Nations. As the topic only suggests United Nations and its organs, we need to study about these different organs in detail. We need to know the powers, functions, members and all that stuff, right? So this is going to be like a brief summary on what is important and what is not. Then we will see some detailed provisions as well. So what is Security Council? It is having primary responsibility under the Charter of United Nations for maintenance of peace, international peace and security, right? So that means this is the main body which is having the responsibility or the primary responsibility to maintain international peace and security, which is again one of the prime purposes of establishment of United Nations, right? So that means Security Council is having a big responsibility, right? And every single year it will prepare reports on what all actions it has taken for maintenance of international peace and security, and that report will be sent to General Assembly as well, right, for their review, for their consideration, for their recommendation as well. So Security Council is having prime responsibility for maintenance of international peace and security. But who all are members of Security Council? As we saw in last class, who all are members of General Assembly? All the member states of UN will be members of General Assembly. That means 193 countries only will be members of General Assembly, right? They can send maximum up to 5 representatives and each country will have one vote. But what is membership of Security Council? Who all are members? It is having 15 members. That means all the members or all the countries of United Nations are not members of Security Council, but it is having only 15 members. There also 5 will be permanent and remaining 10 will be non-permanent members. Each member, that means both permanent as well as non-permanent members, will have one vote, right? Same like General Assembly, each of these member countries will have one single vote. Under the Charter, all member states are having this obligation to comply with Council's decision. Whatever decision Council takes with regard to maintenance of international peace and security, all the countries will have to abide by that decision. Security Council takes the lead in determining the existence of threat to peace or act of aggression, right? Whether there is a threat to peace or not, with regard to that, Security Council is having complete authority or will take the lead in deciding that factor, right? Accordingly, if there is a threat at all to the peace, then they can suggest some steps that may be taken by the countries. It calls upon the parties to a dispute to settle it by peaceful means and recommends method of adjustment or terms of settlement. So main purpose of United Nations is to be a platform where parties can settle their matters peacefully, right? Rather than fighting, they should be able to settle the matters peacefully. So accordingly, if there's a dispute between parties, it will ask, Security Council will ask them to come together and accordingly would suggest some steps or some terms of settlement. All right. So accordingly, parties may agree to settle the matter in a peaceful way rather than fighting. In some cases, Security Council can resort to imposing sanctions or even authorize the use of force to maintain or restore international peace and security. So if needed at all, it may impose sanctions also, and it may also authorize use of force in case the matter goes out of control. Security Council has a presidency which rotates and changes every single month. All right, so this also is important that it is having presidency which will rotate, right, and which will change every month. Daily programs of work of Security Council, subsidiary organs of Security Council. So there would be some subsidiary organs also, just like you, General Assembly of United Nations, Security Council can also have some subsidiary organs so that it can perform its functions in a better way. Now we saw that there are 5 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members. We should know who all are these 5 different countries, who all are permanent members of UN. The 5 permanent members of United Nations Security Council or UNSC are called as P5. All right, so you can remember this thing. They are together called as P5. There may be a question, who are P5? They belong to which organ of United Nations, right? They belong to Security Council. Who all are these 5 countries? They are China, France, Russia, UK, and US. All right, so these are the 5 countries. You should remember names of all these 5 countries, and you should also be knowing that they are together called as P5. Okay, so these are the 5 permanent members of United Nations Security Council together called as P5. Now, there are 10 non-permanent members also. Non-permanent as in, they will not continue forever like these 5 countries, but they will be elected for 2 years term. That means there is a fixed term for which these 10 member countries will be elected. Non-permanent members are not eligible for immediate re-election. After completing this 2 years term, immediately they are not eligible for re-election, so that all the different countries get an opportunity to be represented as non-permanent members, right? Otherwise, it may so happen that same country is getting re-elected every single time, okay? So non-permanent members will have a term of 2 years and they are not eligible for re-election. It becomes very important, you should remember it. Each member of the Security Council shall have 1 representative. In General Assembly, they can send 5 representatives, but here they can send 1 representative and 1 country will have 1 vote. List of non-permanent members of United Nations Security Council with end of term year. That means when this 2 years term will be ending, that year is also given here. So this list, I have downloaded it from the website, UN website. This will keep on changing, right? Because for some of the states, you would see it's 21. So next year it's going to change. That's why whenever you are reading this thing, right, you should always look for the updated list, not from some random website, but you should look for it from the official website only. All right, official website of UN. From there, you would get list of the present 10 countries. So as of now, this is the list of 10 non-permanent members, and India also is one of them. Its term is ending in 2022. So whenever you are reading this question, other countries may not be that much relevant, but you should be knowing whether India is a member or not. All right, it becomes very important. So try to remember, India will be a member till 2022. Non-council member states. That means countries who are not members of this Security Council. There are more than 50 United Nations member states. That means out of that 193, there are still more than 50 countries. 50 countries who have ratified the charter but have never been member of Security Council. Right? They have never got this chance or opportunity to be the one amongst these non-permanent members of United Nations. A state which is a member of United Nations, that means all those 193 states who are members of United Nations, but not a Security Council's member, right? They are not member of Security Council. They are not coming under those 15 member states, but it is a member of United Nations. It is coming under that 193 countries list. May participate. They may participate in debates and discussions of Security Council without a vote. They cannot vote, but they can surely participate in its discussions when Council considers that country's interests are affected. If a country's interest will be affected, they are having a concern with regard to the matter that will be decided in Security Council, that country may be allowed to participate in that debate or discussion, but they will not have a vote. Both members and non-members of United Nations, if they are parties to a dispute, being considered by the Council, may be invited to take part without a vote. That means both members and non-members of United Nations, even if the country is coming under that list of 15 member countries, or even if it is not, it may be invited by Security Council when the dispute being considered by the Council, it matters to them, right? May be invited to take part in there, but without a vote. In Council's discussions, the Council sets the condition for participation of a non-member state. Right? They may tell what all conditions they need to satisfy and fulfill to be present there, to attend and participate there. All right. So this is some general understanding which you may find it relevant, that even a non-member country can also participate in debates and discussions, but they will not have a voting right. All right. Now, there is a provision with regard to voting, which is under Article 27. With regard to voting, what provision is mentioned? There are three sub-clauses. Each member of Security Council shall have one vote. This we have already seen in that summary part, right? That each of the members of Security Councils, members as in total 15 members, 5 permanent, 10 non-permanent. They will have, each of them will have one vote. Decisions of the Security Council on procedural matters shall be made by an affirmative vote of 9 members. Out of 15, 9 members should agree to it. All right, 9 members should give acceptance with regard to a decision regarding procedural matters. That is first type of voting which we have under Security Council. Second type is decisions of the Security Council on all other matters. Apart from procedural, whatever other matters are there shall be made by an affirmative vote of 9 members. Okay, 9 members should give affirmative vote, including the concurring votes of the permanent members. That means permanent members also should agree to the decision. Agree to the decision of this 9 members, whatever decision they have given, right? All the permanent members will have to agree to it. And then it will be passed. All right, so that is the basic provision with regard to voting. We have two different processes. One is affirmative vote of 9 members. One is affirmative vote of 9 members, including concurring vote of the permanent members of United Nations Security Council, which is none but the 5 countries which we saw. Okay, so this part is some basic provisions with regard to Security Council. We will have one more class with regard to their powers and functions. So for today's part, right, we have these questions. One common question that comes from is from the this part, right? Permanent and non-permanent members. From there, a question is like very common that who all are member countries, who all are non-members, like not a permanent member, how many permanent members are there, how many non-permanent members are there? Those are very common question from this Security Council part that like you may expect, right? So we will see these questions. First one is, who are the permanent members of UN Security Council? That means who all are the five countries who are permanent members of United Nations Security Council? So option is the second one, right? France, Russia, US, UK, and China. That is the correct option. What is the term of a non-permanent member of Security Council? For what duration they are being like appointed, right? What is their term? It is 2 years. So 2 years is the term for a non-permanent member of Security Council, that is the 10 countries which will be there as non-permanent members. Their term of office is 2 years. And after that, they are not entitled to immediate re-election, but at a later stage, they can be re-elected. Which of the following countries is not a permanent member of United Nations Security Council? US, UK, France, and Spain. So as we know, Spain is not a permanent member, right? Because in this list, Spain is not there. The number of permanent members of United Nations Security Council is, how many permanent members are there? It is 5. There are 5 permanent members, and these are the countries: France, Russia, US, UK, and China. Number of non-permanent members of United Nations Security Council. How many non-permanent members are there? It is 10. So option B is correct. Which of the following is not a permanent member of Security Council? Like, this is a very common question, right? They would change names of countries and there can be a question. France, China, Germany, and UK. So which one is correct option here? Option C, Germany. All right, so these are some questions which are from previous year question papers and also some like important probable questions. So that means this is very important to know that there are 5 permanent members, 10 non-permanent members. Permanent will be there forever. Non-permanents will serve a term of 2 years. They are not entitled to immediate re-election. As of now, India is also one of the countries who is a non-permanent member of United Nations Security Council. Okay, so this part is with regard to the general provisions regarding Security Council. Voting, I have not seen much questions from there, but otherwise you can simply, for your understanding, go through this part as well. And this may be something interesting, so I have mentioned it. Otherwise, this is what you need to remember with regard to Security Council, right? United Nations Security Council. Okay, so we have few more provisions regarding the powers and functions of Security Council, which we are going to continue tomorrow. So until then, you can go through the provisions, you can download the BEREC, and then you can go through the provisions as well. All right, so fine, then we'll meet tomorrow. Bye-bye.